Howdy, Wild Russ here.
And Chris, I'm back. I'm sitting here right by you.
Welcome back to another Montana Guys React. Today we're going to be reacting to Drake, Laugh Now, Cry Later.
It's an official music video featuring Lil Durk.
And this is a real reaction. I have no idea what it's going
to
sound like.
I haven't seen any of it, but I'll probably be happy because I get to just look at Drake, right?
Yeah.
I'll be happy. I'll just get to look at Drake.
I mean, yeah, I guess you find him good looking. And yeah, I mean, like, let's be real. He's like half black, half Jewish or something. He's a good looking guy.
I don't know.
He's a good mix.
He's whole good looking.
I did hear Logic on the H3 podcast talking about this song. He says he really likes it.
Okay. So put our earphones on.
Apparently, and I did hear Logic say something like, even someone as big as Drake apparently doesn't always feel like he's accepted in the hip-hop and rap community. But he's just talking about like how even people that have made it sometimes feel like they are not accepted.
Okay.
But I don't know. That's what Logic said. I have no idea. I don't know the context yet. I haven't watched the video.
Okay.
But before we get into this, if you're not subscribed, feel free to subscribe. We want our subscribers to go
up.
And like this video.
I'm ready.
Laugh now, cry later.
Nike World Headquarters, y'all. Beaverton, Oregon. I didn't know that's where they were.
Yeah. Sometimes we laugh, sometimes we cry, but I guess you know now. Baby, I took a half and she took the whole thing. Slow down. Baby, we took a trip, now we on your block and it's like a ghost town.
I like when he does the singier parts. Like he's kind of more singing rapping. Mm-hmm. I actually prefer that style from him more.
Yep.
But that car, holy shit.
What is that car?
I don't even know.
A car that we cannot afford. That's what that is.
That's why we don't know what the fuck it is. There's no point for us looking at that kind of shit because we can't afford
it. It's a car with four wheels under it.
I don't know who Lil Durk is.
I have no idea who Lil Durk is.
Baby, where did these niggas be at when they said they doing all this and all that? Tired of beefing you bums, you can't even pay me enough to react. Been waking up in the crib and sometimes I don't even know where I'm at. Please don't pay that nigga songs in this party, I can't even listen to that. Anytime that I run into somebody, it must be a victory lap, ayy. Shawty come sit on my lap, ayy. They saying Drizzy just snap. This in between us is not like a store, this isn't a closable gap, ayy. I see some niggas attack. And don't end up making it back. I know that they at the crib going crazy down bad. What they had didn't last, damn baby. Sometimes we laugh, sometimes we cry, but I guess you know now.
I like that line, sometimes we laugh, sometimes we cry, but I guess you know now.
Mm-hmm.
And the beat definitely hits hard. Do you think he was really crying for this, or do you think it's staged?
I don't know.
Because those are tears. Do you think that, like,
is that tears or sweat?
Maybe it's just sweat.
There's rolling down there in the kind of the shadows. So, yeah, I think that's supposed to be.
Yeah, but tears. Do you think, like, I know the song's about crying, but do you think this scene was real?
Probably not. I mean, it's hard to cry on command.
Like, yeah, it is.
Except unless I'm watching a cartoon.
Yeah, this guy, that's not true. Dude, you can cry on command.
Well, I'm not crying on command. I'm just crying because I'm crying.
Yeah.
It just makes me cry.
You gotta admit though, if someone saw like the making of this and he was like putting eye drops in his eye to make himself cry, you'd be like, oh, that's kind of shady. Like, it kind of
loses some depth. Well, that's what they do in movies.
I know. It's cooler though when an actor is like good enough to make themselves cry.
Or maybe they just like cut an onion in the room or something.
Oh yeah, that'll make me cry.
Baby, I took a half and she took the whole thing. Slow down. Baby, we took a trip, now we on your block and it's like a ghost town. Baby, where did these niggas be at when they said they doing all this and all that?
I'm in the trenches, relax. Can you not pet a little boy in the club? Cause we do not listen to rats.
We do not listen to rats.
So maybe they're referring to Tekashi 6ix9ine? I mean,
that would be a good guess.
We in Atlanta, I buy her wig. She telling me Tay is the best. Pointed the nigga who act like a killer, but you only one from the net. I'm like the baby, I'm not just a rapper. You play with me, you won't get stretched.
You're gonna get stretched. You play with me, you're gonna get stretched. So he's got a big one.
Is that what that means?
That sounds like some prison shower stuff.
I don't know slang, to me, that's like, I'm making up something in my head. If you're like gonna mess with me, I'm gonna mess you up, kind of.
Okay, let me back this up and actually put the captions on. I'm sorry, because I probably butchered it. Let's be real. It's kind of mumbly rap. It's mumble rap. It's hard to understand all the words sometimes. They sometimes are all like put together. You can't hear the distinction between the different words.
I'm probably picking out more words in this than I was the BTS video that we just watched.
Yeah. Dynamite.
Yeah. Point at the nigga who act like a killer, but you only one from the neck. I'm like the baby, I'm not just a rapper. You play with me, you won't get stretched. Bring Drake to the hood, surround Drake, around Drakes. Even though I got a case, I'ma do what it takes. And I've never been embraced, and the money's hard to make.
And I've never been embraced. That's the line that Logic was probably talking about. Because he's like one of the most famous rappers now alive.
Yeah.
And he has never been embraced. That's all in his head.
Yeah. Because, I mean, how is he not embraced?
And money's hard to make. I mean, what does that actually mean for him? Like, money's hard to make, but I guess it's all perspective, because he obviously has more money than a lot of people that, like...
He's got some pocket change.
Yeah, let's be real. Like, people... Like, there's Mexicans that are, like, picking fruit for us for nothing.
For near nothing.
Or maids, you know, that make, like, nothing to, like, clean toilets and shit.
Mexicans, Guatemalans... People from Honduras, people that come up from the South, because that's who is willing to pick.
Some people work their ass off at Walmart and make nothing too, so I mean...
I think a lot of people work their ass off at a lot of things for near nothing.
Yeah.
I mean, look at the very big divide in wealth. It's not evenly distributed, not even close. But this guy's got some pocket change.
Yeah. I'ma do what it takes, and I've never been embraced, and the money's hard to make. So I bet they on their face right now. The f*** off the block, what wrong with you? The guy tackled Drake and was like, get off my block. Which maybe they're talking about the hood, not being accepted in the hood. I don't know.
Do you know who the guy was that tackled him?
No.
I'm glad you don't, because I didn't.
I don't think Drake actually grew up in the hood. So maybe that's why he feels like he doesn't have the credit as a rapper. Because he didn't grow up from the ghetto. There's this whole thing that, like, if you have street credit and you grew up in the ghetto, that you're, like, a better rapper. Or, like, you should have more notoriety in the rap community.
More clout. You paid your dues.
So maybe he feels like he doesn't fit in with certain communities. But I think it's all bullshit. Anyways, I think it should be about the music, man.
Anything I'm saying is just conjecture. I'm clueless.
I think it's more about honesty and the music. Because everybody's life is fucked up if you look deep enough. Don't matter where you're from. I know that they at the crib going crazy down bad. What they had didn't last, damn baby. Sometimes we laugh, sometimes we cry, but I guess you know now. Baby, I took a half and she took the whole thing, slow down.
What is it he took the half of and she took the whole? What is that? I don't know who she is either. Is that his... girlfriend? Is that his wife? I know nothing about Drake, other than I'll look at Drake.
See, I think she's pretty.
Maybe he's talking about the paycheck. Looks like she could have taken the whole paycheck without everything that's piled up in those packages.
Oh, dude, that's exactly what it is.
Is that, like, what that is?
Well, or it's a reference for her taking all his money. Nike is expensive, man.
I know. I don't have any Nike right now.
You could probably pay, like, a lot of people's rent for a whole year with all those shoes they had. And then some. They say that, like, most Nikes are made overseas by slaves.
Like most everything is.
Well, yeah, cell phones and...
Yeah, it's like, what's made in the U.S. now? Very little.
Well, they have cheap labor overseas and they can sell it for a shitload over here.
And the CEOs can make lots of money. Baby, we took a trip, now we on your block and it's like a ghost town. Is that a reference to it being COVID? It's like you're on your block and it's like a ghost town, by any chance? Where did these niggas be at when they said they doing all this and all that? When he tell the story, that's not how it went. No, they be lying 100%. Moved out of the rest and forgot about it been. Now they just called me to tell me come get it. Got that boy off and I don't want no credit.
That kind of made more sense to me. It's talking about people putting on a front in the rap community and pretending to be more gangster than they actually are.
Okay.
And how they're just really lying. And I guess in this, he's trying to be more vulnerable and more real. Credit. If it was me, they wouldn't regret it. Let me be dead, and now they won't get it. Yeah. Heart is still
beat it, my niggas still eating. Backyard, it look like the garden eating. Pillow talk with him, she's spilling the tea. And then Shawty came back and said she didn't mean it.
Shanti.
I know that they at the crib going crazy down bad. What they had didn't last, damn baby. Sometimes we laugh, sometimes we cry, but I guess you know now.
What are you doing?
What?
Wait. Yo, you straight?
Yeah, I'm good. No, I'm good.
Dog, we literally on there like me, Odell, we got...
Oh, it's been a long fight. It's been a long fight, and I just had to have a warrior spirit, and that's all. So I'm just...
Don't start that.
No, I'm good. I'm just regrouping.
You sure?
You got a tissue?
No. Why would...
Okay.
Maybe you never experienced that, but on the oil rigs, and I imagine in like in the hood or with your buddies, you know what I mean? Like sometimes like you have to act tough. You want to like not show your emotion, show that you're crying because you feel weak, and it could be looked at as weakness, or you can make fun of for it.
I get that. I just cry anyway.
And I just had to have a warrior spirit, and that's all. So I'm just...
Don't start that.
No, I'm good. I'm just regrouping.
You sure?
You got a tissue?
No. Why would...
Okay.
Yo, it's... Bro.
Okay. Let's get the...
Baby, I took a half and she took the whole thing and slowed down. Baby, we took a trip, now we on your block and it's like a ghost town. Baby, where these niggas be at when they say they doing all this and all that?
CLB. Is that like a dedication to somebody that's passed away or something? There's
is
a
that
rose.
CLB?
I don't know what CLB means.
What is the top comment? Drake really got us watching a 5-minute Nike commercial. No shit, he probably was sponsored by them.
Dude, he got some pocket change after doing this video from Nike.
The dislikes are probably Adidas supporters. That's funny. Definitely he was being vulnerable in this video. And he was talking about people that are not authentically representing themselves.
Sounds like it, yeah. But there's probably some specific individuals in mind that he's referring to, that people that are totally into the rap community probably get this totally, whereas I just don't.
It's not my favorite Drake song. It's okay. The beat was awesome. I would rate it, honestly, a good C+. I just don't know the context as well as other people.
It doesn't really speak to us because we don't have any Nikes, for God's sakes.
Yeah.
And we're not really part of a rap community. So some of the just whole phraseology and what have you, I'm clueless. So yeah, I'd give it a C+, B- for just songs. It's got a good beat. Give it an A+ for looks, though.
All right, that's about it. If you're not subscribed, feel free to subscribe. We want our subscribers to go
up.
Like this video by Russ.
And Chris.
Love you long time. At least we're authentically gay.
We are authentically gay. I'm Gold Star.